that says we should head out. And one other irrelevant and fake comrades say that you should not come out. You can see that we have won now. We ask you to come and you have come. Now let me hand over the microphone to the people's comrades. Comrades of the Kalakawas. Before you touch, you must give him 7 posters. I salute your bravery. I salute your resolve. I salute your determination. I salute your commitment. I salute you standing up here. I am personally proud that you have answered this prayer. You have come in from all the nooks and crannies of our great city, Kaduna. Men, women, the young and old, the blind, the dumb, the crippled. I salute all of you. We are here as patriots. We are here as conscious citizens of our great country. We are here because we believe in justice. We are here because we believe in peace. We are here because we believe in the progress of our country. Nigeria is sick. Our leaders have destroyed our hospitals. They have destroyed our schools. They have destroyed our roads. Now they are destroying our lives. We must say no to it. President Jonathan Goodluck must listen to the people. The people have spoken. If democracy is about government of the people, for the people, by the people, you must listen to the people. The people of this country are tired of corruption. We are tired of ineptitude. We are tired of incompetency of leadership. We are tired of leadership that have no concern for our lives. We are tired of leadership that has no direction. We are tired of unconscious leadership. We need, if I say people, you say revolution. People!
Revolution!
People!
Revolution!
People!
Revolution!
People! We are marching towards a revolution in Nigeria. The people of Nigeria have long been deceived. We have long been denied our fundamental rights. We have long been treated as aliens. Our leaders treat us with contempt. The governor is not the government. The president is not the government. The people are the government.
We are the government.
We are the government. And we will continue to be the government. And because we are the government, we said price of petrol must be 600. We will not accept 97 Kobo. We will not accept 97 Naira. We need 65 Naira. We will not 50 Naira. From 65 Naira, we want to go forward. Not forward. The people of Kaduna, you are out here. The day you came out in the last 2-3 days, the curfew has been imposed on you. There is no curfew in the constitution of Nigeria. There is no curfew in Nigerian law. If you break curfew, you break no law. The curfew is an illegal law. It is an unlawful law. It is an anti-democratic law. It is an anti-constitutional law. We are here not because we have the permission to be here, but because our constitution says we should be here. We fought for democracy, we fought the military, we are going to fight this government. We should all know it very well that democracy is not a gift, it is not a title, it is our fundamental inalienable right as human beings. We have the right to express our opinion
either through protest,
through rallies, or through anything we want to do. I was once a political prisoner.
Yes, we know.
We fought for this democracy when the likes of Okonjo Iweala and Desani Alibaba were here. I have been to Kaduna prison.
Yes.
I have been to Siliguri prison.
Yes.
I have been to Port Harcourt prison.
Yes.
I have been to Enugu prison.
Yes.
I have been to Aba prison.
Yes.
I have been to Owerri prison.
Yes.
So nobody in this country can tell us about democracy. This democracy was being fought by the likes of the late Sheikh Ghani Fawemi.
Yes.
This democracy was fought by the likes of Dr. Bekou Razzoukouti. This democracy was fought by the likes of Amini Kano. This democracy was fought by men and women who stood to defy military dictatorship. On no account should anybody tell us about democracy. Okonjo Iweala don't love this country more than us.
Yes.
Democracy is a fundamental right of every citizen.
Yes.
Nigeria is sick.
Yes.
Nigeria is sick.
Yes.
Nigeria is suffering from diabetes.
Yes.
Nigeria is suffering from kwashiorkor.
Yes.
Nigeria is suffering from sickle cell anemia.
Yes.
Nigeria is suffering from rheumatism. Nigeria is suffering from poverty. Nigeria is suffering from syphilis. Nigeria is suffering from gonorrhea. We are here as citizens to show Nigeria of all citizens. We can say people, we say revolution. People!
Revolution!
People!
Revolution!
People!
Revolution!
Now I'm saying it out there. I'm going to go to the house.